I can't take it. It's a great big atlas. Yeah, I'm feeling dumb. When you got what you want, maybe I should start over. Something that you want, open at 'em again. You don't know what you want. Yeah, I'm thinking it over. Just tell me what you want.
Hey everyone, and welcome back to Pucker's Fishkeeping and Builds. On today's video, we're going to be going over a species of angelfish. Personally, my favorite species of angelfish. We're going to be going over the Altum Angelfishes. The Altum Angelfishes can be pretty challenging to keep, but worth it. These guys get up to 12 inches tall, being one of the biggest species of angelfish out of the angelfish family. And just like Discus says, you should keep a group of them of 6 or more, and it'll make your fish tank fascinating and awesome. I used to have 6 of them in my aquarium. They stand out completely, but like I said earlier, these guys are pretty sensitive and can be challenging to keep. So on today's video, we're going to be going over their origins, their habitats, their care, their feeding, their behavior, their tank mates, their tank setups, as well as some breeding and spawning footage of these species of fish. Also, if you guys are new to my channel, remember to subscribe, so I'll be posting new content about different species of fish every week or every other week. As well, I hope everybody had a happy New Year's this year, and let's get this video started on how to keep the Altum Angelfishes in your guys' aquariums. The Altum Angelfish are found along the border of Colombia and Venezuela in the Ronco River drainage, including the rios Atapajo and Enderita. They inhabit blackwater lakes and slow-moving streams throughout the region. There's also a population of the Altum Angelfish in the middle of the upper Rio Negro in Brazil and Colombia, most likely a remnant when the Rio Negro and the Ronco River converged directly, until the rising of the Andes Mountains ranged and separated the river systems around 8 to 10 million years ago. During the season for Altum Angels, roughly July through October, when water levels are sufficiently low to allow for fishing, the fish are collected throughout their range. The official collection season for the Altum Angelfishes in Colombia begins in July 1st, and in a good year, they can run all the way to December. Collection occurs in typical fashion for wild angels, with fishers going out by canoe in the dead of night in search of angelfishes by flashlight. Once imported, Altum Angelfishes face variable and unfortunately sometimes less than ideal care in hands of chance shippers and wholesalers and retailers. This is where a significant portion of the health issues with wild angelfishes can take a turn from manageable to terminal. In the wild, these cichlids live in river watersheds and floodplains, where their moderate amounts of water flow submerged with trees and plant roots. And underwater vegetations, they're more frequently found in very soft, well-oxygenated waters. These underwaters feed on smaller fish and invertebrates, and any other food particles in the water. The Altum Angelfish species are an attractive and grateful group of fish. Besides the Altum Angelfish, there are 2 other recognized species of angelfish, known by the Silver Angelfish and the Leopoldi Angelfish, which I'm going to be showing you the 3 different species of these angelfishes to show you the differences. The first one are the Altum Angelfishes. The second ones are the Silver Angelfish, also known by the Scalares. And lastly, the Leopoldi Angelfish. So what do you guys think about these 3 different species of angelfish? Personally, my favorites are the Altum Angels. They can be challenging, but it's worth it. So let's jump into our care sheets on how to keep the Altum Angels in your guys' aquariums. And as for caring for the Altum Angelfish, this species of angelfish can be really challenging to keep. However, and it is a poor choice for beginner fish keepers. They are prone to hole and head disease and have trouble dealing with nitrates and are susceptible to stress-related diseases. In addition, they're really sensitive to water conditions and need very soft, acidic waters and can be very difficult to feed. So as for canfish species of angelfish, you will need temperatures between 78 to 84 degrees, with your pH range between 4.5 all the way to 5.8, with your water hardness between 2 to 10 dGH. You will need a minimum size tank of 60 gallons, since a species of angelfish gets up to 15.8 inches tall. They have a lifespan between 10 to 15 years, and their kill level, I'm going to say advanced fish keepers. There's also captive bred Altum angelfishes, but they run more higher in price and tend to be more hardier than the wild-caught angelfishes. And as for feeding, like I said earlier, it can be really challenging to feed wild-caught Altum angels. Since this species of fish are omnivores, they will generally eat all kinds of live foods, flakes, and pellets. To keep a good balanced diet, give them high-quality flakes and high-quality pellets every day, as well as feed them brine shrimp, either frozen or alive, or bloodworms as a treat. So foods I recommend are bloodworms, brown worms, mosquito larvae, krill, brine shrimp, high quality flakes, and high quality pellets. And as for the behavior, although they're considered a community fish, Altum angelfishes may become territorial as they grow older. They are reported to be more peaceful fish than other angelfish species. But being a cichlid family, smaller fish may not do well being with them. As they mature, they will pair off, developing a strong nuclear family and defending a territory in which to breed. As well, a nice thing about Altum angelfish is that they don't burrow or disturb plants. So let's jump to our take mates to see what species of fish can be kept with the Altum angelfishes. As for tank mates, I do recommend tetras, flag cichlids, rasboras, discus, scalare angelfish, plecos, keel cichlids, corridoras, grommies, and other peaceful non-nipping species of fish. And as for a good tank setup, I do recommend good filtration. Since species of fish are really sensitive to poor water quality, you will need a heater, since species of fish needs temperatures between 78 to 84 degrees. You can do sand or gravel for your substrate. You will need driftwood, plants, and capato leaves for your decor, and a minimum tank size of 60 gallons with low to moderate lighting. On that, you guys should have no trouble on keeping the Altum angelfish in your guys' aquariums. As for breeding, the Altum angelfish can be really difficult to breed. For years, it was considered to be impossible to breed. More recently, it has been successfully bred by some hobbyists, and captive bred specimens are now officially available. They are open breeders and prefer to spawn on submerged roots and tree branches in the wild. They are difficult to sex, so it's best to start with a small school, about 4 to 8 fish, and then let them establish a pair. The pair will need to be properly conditioned in very clean water to spawn. Supplement the current diet with food rich in protein, but take care not to overfeed them. The breeding water should be soft and acidic and warm, and have your pH between 5.8 to 6.2 with a hardness between 1 to 5 dGH, and your temperature between 86 to 87 degrees. The males sometimes make a loud grunting sound with their jaws when mating. The female will lay between a few hundred to over a dozen eggs on carefully cleaned leaves, and the male will follow and fertilize them. If the parents don't eat the eggs, the larvae and fries are carefully guarded. The eggs will hatch in a few days, and the fries will be free-range fries in a week. So, I hope you guys enjoyed the video about the Altum angelfish. Also, remember to subscribe for future content updates, since I'll be posting videos every week or every other week about different species of fish. I hope to see you guys soon, and remember to subscribe for future content and updates in my future upcoming videos.